Hey guys, I bet you didn't expect to see me so soon popping up back on your feed within a week of my last video. That's got to be a personal record for me. Okay, I'm gonna ask right now, what do you prefer? You can leave this in the comments and I'll use this information for my next video. This kind of lighting or that kind of lighting? Oh, that's tough. I'm going to go with artificial lighting after all. Okay, today's video, I have decided to create a type of video for myself, which is called Chill Chats. It's basically like my podcast, but not. It's just me using makeup, trying new products. I'm not doing tutorials, so if it's a look you've seen before, that is because it's not a tutorial. And just chatting about life and stuff. That's why I started my podcast. I entirely have stopped uploading on there because I've been working on my new brand and I've just run out of things to say, and I didn't want to just force myself to do podcasts every week and just create filler content. Not my vibe. But I do like talking about stuff still, even just random little topics that might not really suit up an entire like podcast episode. So that is what we're doing today, my friends. Yeah. Loving my skin at the moment. I'm just gonna give myself a little pat on the back to my body for regulating my hormones enough to not give me pimples when I get my period. And I just got my period and I didn't get a breakout. And my skin's looking nice. Like, no, I have like, you know, little scars and stuff. You're just gonna take the wins when you get them, you know? You're just gonna take the wins when you get them. I did a shop on Mecca and Sephora. The first time I've actually ever bought something from Sephora in Australia. I genuinely don't shop for makeup because I've always been inundated with it and it made no sense to buy more when I already had too much. So now that I've taken myself off a lot of PR lists, I'm finding that I'm getting hardly any parcels except from the brands that I actually really, really love, which is really exciting and brings me back to that feeling that I used to have when I started my channel and getting makeup. Like that exciting, ooh, like a new product. It's not just, oh crap, there's so much of it. Like, gotta give this to someone, gotta give this to someone. And it's just like the same kind of product, just in a different color now. It's like, I actually get excited when I get the makeup products sent to me. So that means that when I want to try new makeup, I have to buy it myself, which is actually amazing. And I'm not just saying that because that's so, I actually have to buy it myself. No, I actually am excited about that because I can see how much it costs, what the reviews were like. I can pick the right color for me. I can just do a bit of research on it so I can go into it with a bit more background info than I used to have. And it also means that I'm more invested in the result of the product because I've spent my personal money on it. So it's actually been really good. It's a weird feeling to get makeup and be excited about it, which sounds depressing, but it's true. When you're so used to being flooded with it, it kind of numbs that feeling after a while. So with all that being said, I basically bought foundations. Yeah, that is literally just basically what I bought from both our websites and a few other products, mainly foundations, because they're really the only products that I get like ultra excited about. I don't really get excited about eyeshadows. I don't need any eyeshadows or bronzers or anything like that, but foundation, sign me up, baby. Okay, so I bought two foundations and I'm wondering which one I'm going to talk about. I bought the, because I've tried them both, and that's also something that I want to start doing. Instead of doing first impressions where I only share with you my initial feedback, I'm going to wear the foundation off camera and then talk about it in a video, because then I can actually give you my lived experience using the product, so I can tell you how it held up, how it was during the day. Yeah, it got really shiny, oily, all that kind of thing. So both of these foundations I've already worn before. Actually, before I get into that, I'm gonna use a primer because I wanna do that regardless. This was a product that I was sent. It is the Il Makiage No Filter Poreless Base Smoothing Primer. I used their products in my last little chit chat video and I wasn't impressed with the eyeshadow quad, but I've been using the blush and I really enjoy it, the blush. So as with all brands really, it's kind of just hit and miss. You take the products you like and you leave the ones that you don't. It looks like this. It is just a clear gel. It kind of has like the Benefit Professional consistency, and I just apply it to the areas basically around my nose and my forehead that tend to show the lines and little pores more obviously or more easily. I mean, it doesn't fully obviously get rid of them because skin has pores and that is a natural thing, but it just helps to kind of smooth them over a little bit. I just got Botox on my forehead and I'm loving life, so you'll see me try to be like, show emotion in my with my eyebrows and nothing will happen. Except I get like a squint here. But I love it. It just makes my forehead so smooth and like no lines, and foundation just looks much nicer. I have the Morphe Hint Hint Skin Tint. And I also have the Mecca Max 2-in-1 foundation and concealer. So this is like a more natural foundation that you guys suggested I try. And this is a full coverage foundation. I don't think this shade is going to be, I have two shades of this. I don't know if it's going to be, oh, this one might actually suit today. I haven't tried this color. Okay, I'm going to use this one here because this one I took photos and documented my experience wearing this on my phone. So I'm gonna post this on Instagram. I will also talk about this and wear it in a video a video in the future, actually, not my next video, because my next video I might have received the Sephora stuff, but I will use this in a video because I really liked this. I liked both of these, which is awesome because nothing worse than buying a product that you hate, obviously. So we've got MW8 Beach. I wore this when I had just done, Friday. I wore this on Friday when my tan was like, popping. But this one is LW5 Butter, and now that my tan is fading a bit, I think that this is going to be a better option. Let me check how much this is. Like, this is the information that I probably should have shared in my last try on videos. I don't really know why I didn't do that. I think I was just, I don't know, you just get stuck in a routine. But I want to share with you guys what it costs because it helps you. If you like the finish of it and it's affordable, then maybe you'll try it. But if you don't know what the price is and you think it's expensive, then maybe you won't bother trying something that you actually would have loved if you did try it. Okay, $30. $30. That is good. That is good. Actually, let's see how much the Morphe one was. $28, damn. And I do have a discount code for Morphe. I think it's Loz Curtis. I haven't promoted it in so long. I think it's Loz Curtis, but that will only work on the Morphe website and not on Mecca. Damn, $30, that's awesome. Okay. Okay, that color is going to be too light. Let me try it on my chin. I can always mix in the darker shade. You know what I've gone back to using as well? I love this brush and paddle brushes in general. All of a sudden I've had a full on 360. I've had a full circle, which is 360, a full circle moment. Fenty Beauty 1110 foundation brush. I'm definitely gonna be out of breath soon because I'm talking a million miles an hour. I'm sorry if you can't understand me. Most people can't understand me most days. Okie dokie, I'm gonna start by applying this on, actually this color, nope. nope. Okay, that's a bit of a shame to waste it. I'm gonna wipe whatever's left on my little bit of a paper towel. So, okay, let's pump a pump of, I just pumped the exact same color into my pile. I didn't check. Oh no, that's so depressing. I hate wasting foundation. Okay, yeah, that's much better. You can kind of see the color difference. Let's hope that is enough. Ooh, okay. Whoa! I wore this foundation in my launch video. This is like, oh, that's a really good sound effect. It is full coverage. Like, it reminds me of the Kat Von D Locket Tattoo Foundation, but I didn't enjoy that, so this must be different enough for me to obviously enjoy it. It's just like heavy duty. This is not one of the foundations that you'd wear if you're looking for like natural makeup, like a subtle foundation. This is when you want coverage, you want to do the full glam. I think I need to turn down the exposure on my camera because it's looking blown out. Okay, I just turned it down a tad and you can kind of get a better idea. I've moved a little bit closer to the camera so you can, oof, it just goes on there. It covers up that redness I had on my nose. The reason I like this brush is that I really push it into my skin and into my pores, and that's, I think, also what smooths over them, makes them look less obvious. Obviously, when you go to remove the foundation, you want to make sure that you're removing it properly, but I remove my foundation with cleansing oil and then a muslin cloth. I wipe it all off with that, and then I go in with my face wash. So I double cleanse and it always gets it off and I don't get, you know, breakouts from foundation on my skin. So that's how it looks. I think there's this like automatic stereotype that more affordable products are going to be less effective, or there's got to be a compromise somewhere, you know, especially with when brands release their own, when companies like Mecca release their own products, it's very easy to assume that it's going to be like a lower quality product or something because it's a house brand. I don't know why house brands, at least in my eyes, I don't know how you guys feel about it, just have that stigma attached where it's kind of like the thing about like Kohl's or something. They have all their brands of food, but then they come out with their own brand and it's normally cheaper than all the other brands, and then you're kind of like, maybe I'm just gonna stick with my usual brand because I know it's good quality, I know it tastes good, I don't want to sacrifice something because it's, you know, that's why it's cheaper. But this is one of those examples where it's good to ditch that thought process because it really doesn't do you any favors. This is a really great product. Can you see? I'm gonna stop and not move so much so that the camera stays focused on my skin. And you can hopefully see, let me turn down the exposure again, because it'll show more detail. There you go. You can really see how it looks on the skin. I have so much foundation left. I hate that. I really hate that. When I'm applying foundation to my forehead, more so when I have a tan, I like to apply it at the center of my face and then blend whatever's left on my brush up into my hairline, because what that does is prevents me from having, first of all, an orange hairline, and prevents the stark difference between my part and my skin. I mean, you're always going to be able to see it because my skin is obviously not naturally that color, but it just stops it from being like white and then like a tannish color. And it also just, yeah, stops that makeup buildup in my part. And I don't really need coverage there. It's the same thing along here as well. You want to blend it into your hairline so that it, you know, obviously is seamless. But most of the time, unless you have breakouts along the hairline, you don't really need to be applying a lot there. So I'm just pushing it into my skin here. And that's why I like this Fenty brush as well, because the paddle brush can't really do this because it's not thick like this is. This can work as a paddle brush where you're smoothing it down, but it also has that bit of chubbiness where you can push it into your skin and like stipple it on, which is actually what the product says to do. You could literally just keep going with it. However much you need is how much you apply. I used the Fenty concealer yesterday, I think, and that seemed to do a good job. So let's try that again, shall we? I'm going to use it with the same brush, actually. Oh no, I used that with the other foundation. Ooh. I hope this works then. Considering how obsessed I am with the Fenty foundations, I don't really use this concealer as much. I'm not really sure why, actually. This blends really nicely in with the foundation. I'm always scared of mixing products because I don't know if the formulas are gonna gel well together, but, and I don't want to apply my concealer and then have it take off my foundation. That's like the number one thing that I'm worried about. So this doesn't seem to do that. I don't really need concealer. I'm also applying it just because I want some lightness. Let me see what the lighting's like without. So that's what the lighting is like without. I actually kind of like that. Let me turn up the exposure a bit. I think I need to brighten the exposure when I don't have any artificial lights. Ooh, I kind of like that. Let's just keep it like this for a little while and then I'll put that light back on. It's not a very even distribution of the light though. Now, I will actually turn my lights back on, but at least it gives you an idea of what it looks like in real life with just natural lighting. Gosh, it's a really nice foundation. Let me zoom in a little bit closer for you so you can get an idea of what it looks like. You know what, I'm gonna leave this light, the light off. I actually think that looks nice. I might regret that by the time I get to editing this, but that's fine. Okay, I'm also going to use this baby. I used this yesterday with the, I'm out of breath because I'm speaking too fast. The Morphe Hint Skin Tint. I used this with that yesterday and it was lovely. And I haven't used this powder in ages and I used to be obsessed with it. So let's get back on that bandwagon, shall we? The Morphe Jaclyn Hill JH06, just a slanted brush with a fluffy head. The lighting is going to be constantly changing because it's a cloudy day. So if I go from orange to blue, it's because of that. God, this foundation looks nice in this camera. I hope it looks nice when I'm editing. But yeah, because this foundation isn't dewy or anything like that, you really don't need a full blown setting powder. Otherwise, it's just going to look crepey and icky. And what I always said about this foundation is that it's like a setting powder with 50% opacity. So it's not a full blown, oh, I need to bronze up my ears. It's not a full blown powder that makes your face like, but it sets it enough so that it's not sticky. That's the number one thing I hate about not setting foundation is that it makes my face feel tacky and sticky and my hair gets caught in it. And I just hate that feeling. That's mainly the reason why I'm always wearing powder, even if the foundation doesn't need it. So what this does is eliminates that problem, but doesn't make my face look creepy and old. I mean, I could get away with wearing like 10,000 layers of powder when I was in my late teens, early 20s, because your face can just take a whole lot of powder. But as you naturally get older and develop a few more lines here and there, it does tend to show up more so around like the under eye area. That actually makes quite a nice segue into what I wanted to talk about today, which is the, I don't even know how to even start this conversation, but I feel like no one talks about this, but also people always talk about it. It's getting older and how your body changes and your appearance changes as you get older. And I'm talking older, like from your late teens, early 20s. Like probably from like 24 onwards, I'd say. That was probably like my prime time. And then I think after that, it kind of is not. So I'm gonna say it goes downhill from there. It doesn't go downhill, but it definitely changes. And I think when you're in that prime period, you're not even thinking about it. I think I said this somewhere recently on my page somewhere. I can't even remember where, but it's like, I remember when I was in my teenage years, and I would eat anything and I wouldn't, and I was like 49 kilos or 48 kilos. Like I was tiny and people would always say, enjoy it while it lasts. As soon as you get older, you can't eat that same way because you'll gain weight, like enjoy it while it lasts. And I was like, okay, negative Nancy, like no need to be weird and like make me fear something that hasn't even happened yet. Most of us when we were younger were the smallest we've ever been, but yet never saw ourselves that way. Always saw ourselves, maybe I should put a trigger warning on this video before I get into this topic more. If you have issues with food or weight or eating or anything like that, just proceed with caution or don't watch, because I don't know what might trigger some people or not, but this is just something I want to talk about. Yeah, you didn't see yourself that way. You thought you needed to lose weight. You thought you were big in certain areas or flabby or needed to tone up or whatever. And so you basically have been living that same way, in that same mindset, having that same mindset up until now, probably, because I know I have. When I was 49 kilos, I remember posting on one of those question forums, how do I lose weight? I'm 15. I'm 15 and probably weigh like, God, yeah, literally, I think I weigh under 50 kilos. I wanted to lose weight at 15. Like, where did I get this from? It's so absolutely horrifying and really depressing. And it wasn't that my family or my parents were ever like, you need to lose weight or you're getting, because I was always just a totally normal kid. I had a little bit of puppy fat on my body, but that was gone pretty much by, you know, middle of high school. And then I lost the puppy fat and I was so little. It got me thinking to now, when I've noticed, someone said to me recently when I was talking about this another time, so I've been talking about it a bit recently because I feel like no one else is, and every time I talk about it, everyone's like, yes, I know what you're talking about. Someone said recently, like, you age every 7 years or something. I don't know if that's true, like your body changes every 7 years. Yeah, again, don't know if that's true, that's just someone's two cents. But it wasn't until recently, I'm just gonna stop right there for a second. This foundation is gorgeous. I'm gonna go a little bit further back so the lighting's a bit more even. Look how stunning that is, just beautiful. I'm going to use the Fenty Sunstalker Bronzer in Private Island. Oh, this chair's really creaky. Yeah, it wasn't until recently where I was watching old videos back or looking at my old photos and I was like, my face shape is like really different to what it used to be. And it kind of just went and turned into this spiraling few weeks or months of me like trying to identify what had changed. And I've always been petite. I've never had an issue with weight or anything like that. I've never had any reason to criticize my body, basically. Not that even if you're in a bigger body that you have a reason to criticize your body, or if you're in a really, really, really little body, you have a reason. No one has a reason to criticize their bodies because bodies are just like vessels. But anyway, that's another story. But according to society standards, let's just say that, I didn't have a reason to criticize my body. Yeah, it was like, oh my God, is it because I'm getting older? Is it because I'm getting weight? And I think I had actually narrowed it down. It's probably like 75% weight gain, 25% aging. You can tell that I've really thought about this. And I'm trying to detach from it emotionally because I'm trying not to care about it. And I'm reading an amazing book right now called Anti-Diet, which is so insightful and interesting and educational. Like, I normally struggle to stay engaged with books, but this one I'm like looking for any chance to read it. It's just so interesting. The expectation on women's appearances changes every 10 years and it has done since like the Victorian era. It's just fascinating. Like, the first chapter was already so interesting. You can get a free sample on like Apple Books and you can read like the first chapter or so. And God, it's interesting and it's so depressing at the same time. Especially for people of color as well. That's a whole other topic. Anyway, that then led me to a separate issue, which was, okay, I've gained weight. Like, I never weigh myself because I know that that's just such an easy way to also spiral downwards. And I recently weighed myself because I was like, you know what? When I look in the mirror, I like how my body looks. Some of my clothes are marginally tighter, but generally, like, I'm really happy with myself. My face was a bit different because I see that every single day in photos and stuff, and I can tell how it looks a little bit different. But my body is some reason, like, I'm actually happy with how it looks. I have a little bit more cellulite, but generally, like, I'm actually surprised that I'm not as bothered as I probably thought I would have been. So I weighed myself and I was basically like 3 kilos heavier than the last time I weighed myself, which was the heaviest I had weighed myself, which was the heaviest I had been. And the only reason, it's such a funny story, the only reason I had weighed myself back then was because Mia, when I take her to the vet, she refuses to get on the scales and she usually has to go on the cat scales. But this time she wouldn't even go on the cat scales, so I had to stand on the animal scales with Mia. I had to weigh myself first and then weigh myself with Mia. So I was like, oh my God, I haven't weighed myself in years and that's how much I weigh. Ah. And it was, again, it was only like a few kilos heavier than the last time I'd weighed myself. So basically every like 3 or 4 years, I'm gaining a few kilos, which I think is totally natural. But of course, in your head, you're like, society's like, no, And it's this weird situation where you're kind of like, oh, but I'm physically happy with the way I look, but like that number is now like lurking in my head. And what if what's gonna happen if I gain more? Like, it's just, it's like drilled into you from birth. There was something in this book that was like, it's like water that you swim in from birth. Like, it's, you swim in this water from birth. I don't know, whatever the quote was, but you're basically, you succumb to it before you've even had a choice, before you even know what it is. It just lurks. It just is around you. You just exist in it. The expectation that women have, there are expectations on every minority group and majority group. Like, there are expectations on men too. I'm not just saying this is unique to women, but because I'm a cisgender woman, like, that's the only experience I've had. So it's the only experience I can speak for. I was actually really, really proud of myself. When I saw that number, I was like, ooh, okay. Like, I didn't spiral like I thought I might, but it did definitely, it was almost a bit of a relief, to be honest. So I was kind of like, oh, okay, so now I know what's caused the change and this kind of thing, blah, blah, blah. And it's even like, I got a message from someone probably like a month ago, and this person meant this, I 100% with every fiber of my body believe she was being genuine and nice. But she said, well, of course she was being nice, but she said it in a nice way. I'm just gonna use the Il Makiage Big Spender Mineral Baked Blush. I used this in my last video and I've been really enjoying it. She said something along the lines of, you've gained weight, you look beautiful and are glowing, or something like that. Basically saying that I've gained weight and I look beautiful. So it was a compliment, but because of the way that my brain works and has always worked, I was kind of like, oh, thanks. And that's the funny thing, because I didn't see women that are in bigger bodies than me and think, I literally look at them and I think they look beautiful. And I'm not just saying that to be like PC. I genuinely do not look at them and think anything other than like positive thoughts. I think they look beautiful. So it's not that I'm scared of looking like somebody else that is different to me. It's literally just the stigma attached with women gaining weight. Because there is so much pressure put on women to look a certain way and to fit in. And especially, I guess, in my industry, that it's like, even if you didn't want to care, you still kind of care. And that's like this weird thing that I'm trying to talk about, that I don't really see a lot of other people talking about. Like, I'm watching my old videos and I'm like, oh my gosh, my face is like so slim and slender. And I think, okay, so that means that I can either change my diet or I can exercise more. Because now the reason I think I've gained weight is because I'm not exercising as hard as I used to, but I'm also very happy with my current routine. Like, I have a healthy and unhealthy relationship with food, I think. Because I'm always aware of if something I'm eating is healthy or unhealthy. I'm always aware of moderation. I'm always aware of like, oh, you can't overeat this because that's gonna be bad for you. But I think to some degree that's healthy because I don't want to feed my body crap all the time. But I still eat crap. Like, every weekend we eat crap, and then during the week we eat normal food. I was speaking to Reese about this the other day. Like, I don't want to change the way I live my life at the moment. I enjoy my food too much. I just, like, if it's 80% diet and 20% exercise, then I'm gonna have to exercise way more because I'm not gonna change my diet. I get so much joy from the food that I eat. Like, my world revolves around it. I love it. And exercise, I hate it, but I know it's good for my body and my body deserves exercise. And I don't want to do it as a way of punishing myself or like keeping myself in line. You know what I'm talking about? I'm going to use the Il Makiage Gimme More Mineral Baked Highlighter. So the reason I'm saying all of this is because it's necessary for me to come full circle with my point, is that I'm sure many of you, because my age demographic thing on YouTube basically grows with me. Like, I do have people that are 18 to 24, but majority is 25 to 30 something. And so I'm sure that many of you are experiencing what I'm experiencing now. And it's almost like having to come to terms with a few things, that as we age, our appearance is going to change whether we like it or not, and our bodies are also going to change with it. if I can't accept the fact that I'm going to gain kilos, a few kilos as I age every few years, then I'm really going to struggle with the fact that my skin's going to change. I'm going to have more wrinkles. Things are going to sag more. The body's going to hold weight in different areas. Like, if I can't accept the most basic, smallest, insignificant thing now, then everything else going forward is going to be a really tough hill to swallow. And it makes you realize why women especially tend to chase youth. It's because we're so scared of not being that peak version of ourselves that was always celebrated and, you know, looks the most like the societal norm expects us to look. That makes sense. So at some point you just have to be grateful for those times when you looked like that, and not discredit the way you, and not undervalue the way you look now, because it's not like I look that different. Just things have slightly moved around or changed. And overall, like, I love my life and I have such an incredible body that never lets me get, like, I never get sick. I'm always healthy and I can exercise, and I've never been like, you know, that's more than a lot of people can say about their bodies. My body has always been so good to me. And I just hate the idea of ignoring all of that and only criticizing it for the way that it's changed when it's been so good to me for 28 years. It's something that, like, this book is really helping, like, trying to ditch the whole, oh, I've got to diet, I've got to exercise more, I've got to find, like, sometimes you just have to embrace the fact that your body is going to look different, and that's not a bad thing, and that it doesn't change your value or your worth. I'm just using my makeup store premium tri-brow in blonde to quickly do my brows. I just think it gets to a point where you have to just let go and accept it and stop resisting it so much. You just have so much more to offer than your appearance. There is more to you than the way that you look. Will I continue to struggle on and off with this whole thing? Definitely, because I'm human, and it's unrealistic to think that it's always going, that I'm always going to think this way every single day. Some days I'm going to be like, hell yeah, I look and feel amazing. Other days I'm going to be like, ah, I miss those old days. I wish I still looked like that. I think that's just natural, and for the most part, it's something that we can't really be blamed for, because it's not us that's put these expectations on ourselves. We're just kind of like trying to adhere to them because we all fear rejection. So yeah, I don't know. I've just been thinking about that. Reading that book is very insightful. What I've started doing, I'm going to use the MCO Beauty Blonde. This is like an eyebrow texter pen thing. I find that it's really helpful when I've done my brows with powder and I want that little bit of extra definition in some spots. So what that little pen does is just, yeah, provides me with a bit more definition in certain parts of my brows, which I really enjoy. This is the Milk Makeup Kush Clear Brow Gel that I just used to set them in place. Now, I got sent this in PR last week, and this color is beautiful. I haven't actually, like, audibly gone, ooh, this is a nice eyeshadow, in a very long time. This is the Too Faced Teddy Bear Cute Bear It All eyeshadow palette. Now, this is a really, like, I don't get excited about eyeshadow palettes because there are billions of them, but this is a really nice palette with all of your, like, just handy, earthy, warm brown shades. You know what I'm talking about? But this shade here is stunning, and I know it probably looks a little bit underwhelming, just a normal, that's a better angle. It looks like a normal transition shade. Oh, I don't know what it is about it, but it blends beautifully. The color is stunning. It's just a really nice eyeshadow. And I don't say that lightly, because there are so many eyeshadows that exist on the market and they all kind of do the same thing. But this one just really stood out. Like, it just so effortlessly blends. You're not gonna be able to see. Let me turn the exposure down so that you can probably get a slightly better representation of the color of it. But But even still, eyeshadow never really shows up very well on camera. Yeah, you can't really, it's hard to see. Oh, it is such a nice transition shade. It has that perfect amount of warmth and reddishness to it. My lips are so dry. I'm just applying this all over the eyelid. Gosh, it is such a nice shade. Oh, it even has that darker shade here. I might actually put that on my lids as well. Oh, that's nice. That's a perfect shade to pair with that eyeshadow to kind of intensify it a bit. I'm going to do my mascara and falsies and then I will come back to y'all. I've just put lashes on. Unfortunately, I'm not going to share which ones they are, purely because I just realized that they are mink lashes, which is not something I would normally promote on here. It says that they are cruelty-free, but I don't think that is possible with this kind of thing. So I'm not gonna give credit to the brand. I don't want people to go out and buying them, but I'm also not gonna take them off when I've already applied them. So let's just move on. I've been having a hard time finding the perfect lip liner. I have some, like the Naked 2 by Urban Decay, that has worked pretty well for me up until now. But I'm kind of, I don't know, I feel like it's not perfect. So, I mean, let me give it another chance. This is, yeah, Urban Decay Naked 2. Yeah, I mean, look, I probably won't be able to find one that matches much closer than this. I recently found this Tarte shade, actually, in my drawers, and I hadn't used it before. So this is the Tarte Color Splash Lipstick in Beach Babe. Ah. Oh, now that is a good lipstick. Oh man. It reminds me of the Tarte Bare Bud lipstick, which is a different finish. So let me, this one's like right down to the nub of it now, but they are quite similar shades, except yeah, this one is probably a little bit pinky and glossy, not glossy, but quite a creamy finish, where this is very opaque and more of like a satin finish, I'd say. I wouldn't say it's definitely not matte, but a very different finish to the other one. Oh, that's a really nice color. A really nice, like, just staple pink. I mentioned this in the last video, but I have a 15% off discount for the Tarte website as well, which is Loz Curtis. So I'll put that on the screen and in the description box if you want to check it out. Ooh, it tastes metallic. It's probably expired, that's why. I mean, I hadn't used it before like a couple of days ago, but I've had it for a couple of years. Yeah, whatever. I'm really not enjoying the taste of this. It tastes like blood. Yummy. Just before I go, back onto the topic of the appearance transformation thing. I think it's so hard to come to terms with our appearance changing because we're told to fight it, or not necessarily told directly, but indirectly, very subtly, through advertising, through everything we see online, really, or just in person everywhere, just bombarded with it in every facet of our lives. We're encouraged to fight it, and we're sold products that will help us fight it, or procedures that will help us fight it, rather than embrace it, or just accept it. You don't even have to embrace it, just accept it. And I think that makes all the difference, because if we're told to fight something, it's usually bad, right? We only fight or push away things that aren't good for us or that could be detrimental to us in some way. But that whole process isn't detrimental, and it's not something that we need to, you know, go up against. It's just a natural part of life and part of aging and part of being a woman, and our bodies are always going to change. We're not always going to be like 19 years old or 22 years old. Like, I want to avoid trying to constantly look that way when I know at some point, and I'm probably at that point now, it's going to be impossible because our bodies are never going to look the same as they did 3 years ago, 4 years ago, 5 years ago. We're always changing. Some days will of course be easier than others, but I'm just trying to stay on top of that negative self-talk, I think. Excuse me. I wanna know if you guys understand what I'm talking about. Do you also struggle with that same kind of thought process? Of course, if you're my age or older. Then a lot of women say when they're in their 30s, they just stop caring as well, which I will be happy to embrace. And I mean, I don't care in many ways, but I can still feel there's an undercurrent of like, resist, 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 and I don't want to feel that way. So yes, those are my deep thoughts for today. I hope you enjoyed today's version of Chill Chats. I quite like this format, and I hope you enjoyed seeing me apply this beautiful foundation. This is how it looks up close. Let me get even closer for you so you can see every little nook and cranny. Gosh, it's nice. Thank you so much for watching, guys. I love you. I'm sending all of my positive vibes and good thoughts to you on this fine day. You're beautiful. You don't need to change anything. You don't need to be smaller or bigger or curvier or slimmer. I know we're always going to be up against it. We are always going to be going against the grain by accepting ourselves. And that is so depressing. That is what it comes down to. It is an uphill battle, just accepting yourself. That's not even loving yourself. That's like accepting yourself. It feels like sometimes anyway. Thanks for watching. Have an amazing day and I'll speak to you all next time. Bye guys. Just quickly popping in to give you an update on how the foundation's looking. As you can see, I've got some shininess around my T-zone and on my forehead. That doesn't bother me too much. Normally I would be touching up my foundation at this point anyway, just with like a bit of powder or something. Everything else still looks amazing. I haven't had a big day or anything though, and I only had soup for lunch, so I haven't really been eating like big bread rolls or anything like that. But regardless, it's a beautiful foundation and I am still in love. What I actually like to do is just grab, this is a bit of toilet paper, or a tissue and just dab my face, and that gets rid of the majority of the oil anyway, as you can see. Like that's enough for me to, that's basically what I would want the powder to do. So if you're not close to a makeup compact, then just give that a go. It's like blowing paper, but probably cheaper.